Hey guys, how you doing? Steve Laff here. Just figured I'd do a little vlog. What's going on? You guys staying out of trouble? What are you doing watching YouTube videos? You should be out there, you know, cutting the grass or, you know, doing the dishes. Don't you have a honey-do list from the wife? Honey-do this, honey-do that? Hey, what is it with these females? They always want to drive the bus. It's like, I'll drive the bus. You get in the back. You get in the back. I'm in charge of the finances of this house. I'm going to drive the bus there. You know, like a school bus. You ever see them? They want to be in the driver's seat. Hand over your check, your weekly check to me, and I'll give you, you know, spending money for the week. And, you know, while you're out working your ass off all week, I'll be power shopping at the mall. With me and my friends, we're gonna go power shopping. Yes, yes, yes. We have to control the finances of this house. It's just the way it is. And you know your father did that to your mother. Hand over the check, boy. Yeah. So you know, I do these videos for a joke. So I don't want, you know, the females to get too pissed at me. You know, sometimes I do these jokes. Seems like I'm slowly losing my female subscriber base. But it's all fun, you know. I got more guys who watch my shit, so we'll joke around about the females. Why not, you know? It's what guys do. You know, if the female's gonna censor you, and she'd laugh about it, but
I'm probably gonna unsubscribe to this guy because, you know, he's making fun of the females. Yes, it is unacceptable behavior on YouTube.
Hey, a little funny story is, I only been married once. I consider myself a one-time loser. I got married, didn't work, and I said never again. You know, I'm a one-time loser. All you three-time and four-time losers, you know, keep trying. You might find one sooner or later. But anyway, I got nothing against marriage. I think it's a good institution. I think you guys should all try it at least once. You know, it's quite the experience. No, there's nothing wrong if you get, you know, it's like poker, you know, or gambling at, you know, the casino. It's a gamble. It's a chance. You know, you throw the dice. Whether you make it or not, that's to be seen. But, you know, I'm not a gambling man, so I did it the one time, and that was it for me. But, you know, a lot of guys are married, are happily married, or, you know, they're married, not happy, and keeping their mouth shut, you know? or they're married, and they're hoping that it gets better, or, you know, hey, some of, you know, I talk to guys that are married, and they're happily married, and I, you know, I just joke around. I'm just trying to get a laugh out of some of you guys. Some of you guys are,
I can't believe you would say that. It is, you know, hurting my feelings because I love my wife. I love my wife so much. She's a wonderful woman.
She probably is. I got nothing against anybody. I just try to joke around, like I said, you know, be a loose pulley. It's kind of a lot of entertainment value for some of you clowns. Some of you guys need to laugh, you know? I need to laugh too. I do these videos so I can laugh. I don't care about you guys laughing. I want to laugh. After I'm done doing the videos, I watch them. I laugh myself. So sometimes I'm watching three, four times to get some laughs. If I had a hard day, I need a flipping laugh. I need a whole bunch of laughs. There should be more funny videos out there. You know.
Oh no, we have to watch the technical videos. The technical videos is where it's at. And I need more technical videos. Yes, yeah, I do. You know, I'm soaking up the technical videos because I need all the knowledge I can get. Yes, yes.
Hey, every day's a school day, buddy. We all learn every day. If you're out there in the field working, you're gonna learn until the day you die. The longer you're in the field, the more problems you'll come across. It's something, you know, experience. What's experience? It's a problem you come across that you figured out how to fix it. Now that's experience. That's all experience is. We all come across problems every day, and we got background knowledge in different areas that helps us solve that problem. But that's all experience is, you know. And after 30 years, you know how many problems you ran across? A shitload. a shitload of problems. Some of them, you know, you put on the old parts changer head. Well, I'm going to change this part and see if it works. Well, maybe it didn't work. And next thing you know, you're changing 2-3 parts and you're finally, oh shit, man, there it is. Now, you were a parts changer back in the day, but now, when you have that same problem, you know what to do. That's what experience is. That's all it is. You know, and nobody's a super tech. Nobody's a superhero. Nobody is. Oh, they might put on, I put on a good show. I make great YouTube videos. But behind the scenes, you follow the guy, he's just a regular guy, you know? Just a regular guy. You make a mistake, just like if you were going to be doing a job. You'd be making mistakes, too. We all do. Everybody does. So don't be scared to fail. Don't be scared to trip and fall. You fall, get back up, brush yourself off, and start walking again. You know, you trip up again, your ex-wife's out there with her foot, as you walk by, boom, you fall. Get back up, brush yourself off, and continue to walk again. Anyway, I was at this, doing this job with it, at this bleach company, where they make bleach. And I had to, you know, work on an air conditioner, and it was up on a mezzanine and stuff, so. I went there a couple of times to do a couple of different repairs for the guy, and every time I pull up there, you know, they got a big overhead door, and there's all these people outside with these blue containers, you know, wanting to dimming their old bleach container into like 5-gallon containers and pick up a new one, and, you know, to bring the old one in for a recycle and grab a new one and take off. Well, when I was parking in the front and walking in, the lady said, hey, I want a bleach container. I said, hey, lady, you know, I'm there talking to the boss. I'm looking at him, looking at him like, I don't work here. I need a bleach container now. You know, I'm in a big rush. Oh, lady, I don't work here. I want it now. Yes. But anyway, so I'm up there doing the work, and I come back, right? And there's a couple of guys out there in pickup trucks. Well, they're bleach containers, you know, waiting for somebody to come over and work on them. So I look at one guy and I said, shit, what's in there? He says, it's a bleach container. I said, shit, I wonder if I can get my ex-wife to drink some of that stuff. he starts laughing. He says, I wish I could get my last 3 ex-wives to drink some of that stuff, you know? And then the other guy comes out of his truck, starts laughing. He says, you know, I got 4 of I'd love them to drink the bleach. It's like, oh, you fucking crazy bastards. I'm a one-time loser. Here's these 3 and 4 time. They're probably drinking the flipping bleach and looking for another wife after they're done, the dumb bastards. Drink the bleach. You know, it's like, drink the Kool-Aid. Just drink the Kool-Aid and it'll be over. It'll be over in no time. Be over in no time. Yeah, so when I first got married, right, my wife, she lived in, you know, the next state over, was close by the state line, but she lived in the next state over, and, you know, we had a kid and whatnot, and, we first got married, she'd be calling her flipping mother every time the kid burped, you know, long distance.
Oh, you know, hey, mom, the kid burped, and then I pat her on the back, and she spit up, call her again, she spit up.
So, you know, once the kid was born, like, the next month, I get this flipping phone bill, you know, it's like $600 for a flipping phone bill. It's like, holy shit, what are you doing, man? You know, long distance calling. I didn't have the proper plan and everything. I said, shit, well, I'm going to have to get you some of that Gorilla Tape. You know, I know it's stronger than the duct tape. We need to get some of that Gorilla Tape and tape you up, you know, tape up your mouth before I go to work. You can't be calling your mother. Yeah, crazy phone bills. She's over there. She's one of these power shoppers. You know, she goes to the mall with a checkbook and the credit cards and, you know, flipping power shopper. You know, come home with all these flipping bags full of shit. It's like, here I am working my ass off, you know, all day. Come home. What the hell's all this extra shit? You know, pocketbooks and shoes and gotta build a flipping addition just for the shoes and the pocketbooks. You know, I had to go down to town hall and pull a permit just for an expansion to the house for the shoes and the pocketbooks. Crazy, man. These women, they're flipping power shoppers. You got to watch them. Don't give them the run of the finances, you know. You gotta do is, you know, you gotta give them, you give them a couple of, you know, a couple of quarters a day for spending money. That's it. Two quarters. That's it. No more. If you're dumb enough to hand them over your check and, oh, yeah, well, give me some spending money for the weekend. Yeah, I know you run the finances of the house very good. Yes, yes, yes. You dumbass. Anyway, guys, you know, males and females, hopefully I don't lose no subs over this. You know, I'm just joking around, ladies. You know, and it's all in good fun and getting a couple of laughs here and there. And, you know, I didn't mean to throw you under the bus, but it's just all part of being a female, you know. You're thrown under the bus. Thrown under the school bus. Here it comes. All right, guys. Hey, thanks to my loyal subscribers that comment on my stuff. I would say that's what my station's about. I appreciate you guys. And, you know, hopefully, you know, more of you guys will start, you know, commenting on my stuff. And have a good day. And, you know, stop watching YouTube videos and get out there and get some work done. You know, work on the honey-do list. Honey-do this, honey-do that. Yeah, she's going to make you a honey-do list. She'll be having you do the dishes and the laundry. And, you know, next thing you know, you'll be brushing the dog's teeth. And you know, taking out the trash. You got to take out the trash. You know, get to work, make some money. So I can spend it. All right. Hey, hopefully I did. You know, hopefully you don't get your granny panties in a bunch. All right, have a good day.